scandalous. Money, greed, and lust. In this trife life, there ain't nobody you can trust.
Because young brothers need to know this too. But if they're in that lifestyle, don't think dudes won't tell on you. Them same dudes that say they're your comrade, your brother, and your homie, and watch out, watch out. It's the ones that's closest to you that'll hurt you. It's the ones that's closest to you that'll sting you. That's why I lost my brother. Because somebody that's close to us, once again, I mentioned the law of justice, Calvin McLeod, you know what I'm saying? Close to us, stun us, you know what I'm saying? You gotta watch the ones that's closest to you. If those are the ones you trust, those are the ones you open up to, those are the ones you can become vulnerable to, you know what I'm saying? Because you trust them, you know? That was one of the things. I love the fact that my brother had a beautiful heart, but I also sometimes didn't like that his heart might have been too good sometimes, I felt like, because it was times when I told him, this dude is no good, you know what I'm saying? Stay away from whatever, you know? This dude, you know, it was things that happened in the past. I'm not freestyling. I base stuff on things that happened in the past. Our lessons teach us, this is what's in the lessons. If you allow a snake to live, he will sting you again. The lessons say you must remove a snake's head, because if you allow a snake to live, he will sting you again. So when I deal with people and I see their snake, somebody told on one of us or stole from one of us or did something foul to one of us, you know, that was in our circle, grew up with us, you a snake. I say, remove his head. And even if you don't physically remove his head, I mean, cut him off. Cut him out the picture, don't deal with him no more. It don't just mean physically remove his head, it means cut him off, you know? But sometimes, all right, my brother a few times told me, nah, he didn't know no better, he was young back then. You know, like somebody told on us one time, nah, he didn't know no better, he was young back then. You know, other people did stuff like that. And I felt like, no. You know, one person, I wanted to get, and he was like, nah, he didn't know no better, whatever. You know, he had a good heart like that. He would give dude a second chance, a third chance, you know, especially if it was somebody that grew up with us or was cool with us or somebody we knew or something like that. And sometimes you can't always do that, because some people need to be checked and immediately, because if not, then things get out of control. Like if you would have cut that brother off way back when, we can't say what would or wouldn't have happened. Because like I said, everything that happened, I believe, was meant to happen. And if something didn't happen, it wasn't meant to happen. So, you know, you can't change what is. You got to deal with what is. But I'm just saying, you know, for those of you brothers that's coming up, you know that there's somebody or people in your circle who you trust, who you think you can trust, that you may not be able to trust. So I'm just saying that, especially if you're in that lifestyle, when it comes down to it, and dude is facing 25, 15, 20, 30 years of life, 75 life and all that, dudes is going to turn. Not all, but some is going to turn. Some is going to tell, you know what I'm saying? And them dudes that turn and tell, they shouldn't even be allowed to be given a platform to speak to you or to speak to the people. Because,
taking the price while he's staring at the shell, his brother saw what's hell. The trigger man made bail, and you wouldn't pay the boy his mail and sacrificed your fucking family. But that's betrayal, betrayal, betrayal.
Money, greed, and lust. In this trife life, there ain't nobody you can trust.